Welcome to this brief guide on how to separate scroll directions on macOS. If, like myself, you use the trackpad on your Mac when you're out and about, but regularly use a mouse with a physical scroll wheel when you're located at your workstation, you'll have found the pain of natural scrolling. Today I'm going to show you how to resolve this. Here you can see I have natural scrolling enabled for my trackpad, and that makes perfect sense based on how you would normally use the scrolling functionality on a trackpad. However, if you have a mouse with a physical scroll wheel, you'll invariably have found that the natural scrolling option doesn't really make sense for how the scroll wheel on a mouse has traditionally worked for decades. And so you can simply hit the radio toggle here to turn that feature off, and that will make the scroll wheel function as you would normally expect. However, if I jump back to my trackpad settings and select scroll and zoom, what you'll see is that natural scrolling has now been disabled here as well, which is not what I would like. macOS has these options tied together, and so we're going to need to use a third-party program in order to fix this. That program is called Scroll Reverser. Here I have the website open for it, and I'll include a link to it in the description of this video. Please note it requires macOS 10.12 or later and is available for both Intel and Apple Silicon-based Macs. Simply select the option to download it, and once the program has been downloaded, head over to your Finder application and double-click on the application to begin utilizing the program. When you first do so, you'll get a prompt letting you know that this program was downloaded from the internet and asking, are you sure you wish to open it? Simply select open and that will open the application. You'll then notice a new icon in your menu bar, which is the Scroll Reverser application. What we need to do is click on it and then click on the option for preferences. Here you'll notice it requires two particular types of permissions. So what we'll need to do is first click on the request accessibility permission and then click on open system settings. This is going to open up the system settings direct to the option that you need and simply toggle the radio toggle to turn on Scroll Reverser. You will need to approve it with either your password or Touch ID if your Mac supports that. Once you've done so, head back over to the Scroll Reverser program and you'll need to request input monitoring permission, and then click on the Open Input Monitoring Preferences, and then head back over to your settings application. This process is a little bit different because we need to add the program manually to the input monitoring settings. Simply click on the plus and then find the application file that you have downloaded. In my particular case, it's hidden down here in a folder. Once you select the Scroll Reverser application and then select open, it will then let you know that you need to quit and reopen the Scroll Reverser program for it to have the new permissions. Once done, we can head back over to our menu bar and you'll see that the Scroll Reverser is there. So now we're going to open up those preferences again, and we have a few options available to us. The first we need to select is Enable Scroll Reverser. Once we enable this, we can customize whether it will reverse the vertical or horizontal or both settings, and then we can choose which devices it will reverse. So because I have natural scrolling enabled already on my Mac, I don't want it to reverse it for my trackpad, but I do want it to reverse it for my mouse. Then we can select the option for app, and we can make sure that we tick the button that says Start at Login. This will ensure that the program runs every time we log in to our Mac. Now I can see that it's enabled. I can also tick here if I wish to turn it off at any time. So now let's see how that works in action. I can simply use my mouse as I would normally use, and then I jump back over to my trackpad and I can do it, and it still works just the way I would expect as well. And that is how you use Scroll Reverser to separate scroll directions on macOS. I hope you found this tip extremely useful, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.